Hello, hi all, and welcome back to my channel. So in today's tutorial, we'll be diving deep into the list editing part, because I see a lot of people are not familiar to this particular use case out. So we'll see what all things we can do in terms of list editing. So without wasting any further time, let's jump onto the instance. So what exactly is list editing, first of all, understand. So for an instance, if I go to incident table, so you can see the list of records, okay, over the module. And if you double click on any of this entity, for example, short description, you have the capability to edit it out and to change it out. So for example, if I make it to admin, so, and if I click save, so it will get updated over the record. And the same thing you can do over any field, which you get, not all the fields out, okay, but you will be seeing on the same. In some time, so you can do the same. So you can see the record got updated with admin. Again, the similar way you can do for priority, reference fields, and so on. Okay, so today we'll be diving deep into this list editing part, how we can control this out over the platform. So if you want to make the settings global, right, if you want to disable the settings or make certain fields non-editable, okay, across the platform, so you can do it. What you have to do, you have to just go to system property. And over here, you can see the UI properties, right? So just click on that. And over here, you have to just search for, because there are tons of properties, right? So search for list editing. So you will be seeing two properties. So the first property is enable list editing. Okay, so what exactly it means? If by default it's selected to yes, okay, that's the reason we are able to do the list editing, okay? If it's not selected to yes, then what will happen? We will not have the capability across the platform to edit anything on the list, okay? If you want to see the demo, so let's do this, okay? I've just deselected it out and I will scroll down to save. So the property got saved. Now, if we go to incident, so what we were able to edit now, ideally it will not be editable for us. So if I click over here now, so I'm just clicking over the list, but nothing is happening. Why? Because it's not editable for me. I've clicked on this thing, plus this thing, and so on. So this is the first property. Now, coming back to the properties itself, now if you want to make it editable, right? I will just make it yes. The next property is list of element type, comma separated, cannot be edited in the list editor. So here you can add if your project has any requirement, right? That this type of field should not be editable on the list view. You can edit over here. Maybe it reference, document ID, or even a string field. Okay. You can restrict it from here. So out of the box, there are few fields which are already restricted over the list view, which are like HTML, document ID, template, and so on, right? So you can manipulate these things out from the list editor. So you can try it on your own. I've just enabled this list out. Okay. So that, and make sure whenever you enable this particular property or whenever you are playing this around this property, as it's under system properties, it will be applicable for the entire system. Okay. It will not be on the single table, right? It will be applicable to the entire instance. So be very cautious whenever you are taking any decision to play around the same. Now, other question which will be buzzing in your mind is like, okay, for an instance, if I want to do certain or disable certain list editing only on one table, okay, how I can do that, okay? So now we will be exploring on that particular option. So for an instance, let's go to the incident table. And now we want to disable the list editing, not for the entire instance, but just for this particular table. So how you can do that? So for that, we have list control defined on the table. So how you can navigate to that? I will just close this out. So you have to just right click on the list. Okay. Just go to configure and there's a list control. So just go to the list control. Over the list control, it's just loading. Okay, we'll give some time for it to load. So list control is a place where you can play around it. Okay, you can make some configuration which will be applicable to your list. Okay, for that particular table, because you can say there is a table entity out there. Okay, table incident. So whatever you do over here will be applicable only for incident table, and it will not apply to any other table. Okay, so over here, list editing type, right? You can see save immediately. So whenever you double click, you pour some values out there. Okay, and as soon as you click on this check mark, okay, it will immediately get saved. We have seen earlier, right? We have other option over there, save data by row. So what exactly happens that if you are editing on multiple columns out, okay, it will save as a one entity. Okay, it will not have multiple updates out there. But down there is an option called disable list editing also. So if we click that particular option out, what it will do, it will disable the list editing for this table only. Okay, no other table. So let's do that. So I have saved it out. Okay, now if we go to incident.list, and now if I click, see, nothing is happening again, right? So that's the power of list editing. Okay, now if I go to list control again, and let me just disable it out. So I will just go over here and save immediately on the cell edit mode. So I just saved it out. You can also define the rules, okay, which are mandatory, okay, in order to do the list edit over here. Okay, so here you can see the edit rules kind of. So if I go back to the incident, not over here, to the incidents, and if I do the double click now, so ideally I should be able to save the record, to update the record again. So I went over here. If I click now, now you can see this particular thing out, right? We are able to edit it now. So this is one way out. Now, if you want to try for another option, okay, there we can define certain ACs out. So for instance, on the list editor, yes, definitely you can define ACs on the list editor. So how? I will show you. So if I right click, first of all, I have to elevate my role, because security admin is necessary whenever you are playing around ACs and all. Just update it out. This, and it has just refreshed my session. So I have that privilege now. So now if you want to define ACs, so what you can do, you configure security roles and you can click simply new. Okay, and now what I want, for instance, type is record. Okay, and we will go with the list edit one. Okay, list edit on which particular table we want to define it out. So I will just go to incident. I just typed it out. It's taking some time. Incident. And I'll go with the star. So star means it's applicable for all. Okay. And I want to define certain role for it. So I want it to be editable only for admins. Okay. So if I save this out, it will create some security settings at the back end. Okay. And what it will do that now, in order to play around the list, okay, list edit, we need to have the admin with us on the incident table. Let's verify it out. So if I go to incident.list, what change didn't get saved? Save. Continue. Okay. Now if I go again to incidents and if I try to edit it out. So I'm able to edit. Why? Because I have that. Let's try to impersonate with some other person out. So I will just go to impersonate and let's select evil tutor, impersonate user. Okay, I don't want this experience. Okay. And now if I go to incident.list, it has only one incident. And now if I try, I'm trying to edit it out, but it's grayed out for me. You can see security prevents writing into this particular field. So because we don't have the admin access for able to do account, okay, this particular error message is coming out. Edit it out. Let's end the impersonation. This is how you can add the rows, okay, or restrict the list editing for a particular row, okay, on particular table. And now we will jump back to the access controls only. Think I have to elevate the role again. Update. Now, if you want to make this setting, okay, only for certain fields, okay, so how you can do that? For example, if you don't want anyone to, apart from admin, to do the changes on the caller field, so now you can select the caller out there. And then, in order to update the caller, the list view, you need to have the admin, okay? And you can try it yourself and check it out. So it will work. So these are the different methods for list editing control. Okay. So this is how we have seen how we can make list editing disabled over the entire system. How we can make certain fields, okay, list editing disabled from the system properties. So under system property, there are UI properties. Then if you want to make disable certain things out on an individual table, then we have list controls. Okay. And if you want to go more granular, right, to the rules and to certain fields out, then we can do it via ACL. So this is all for today's tutorial. I hope you like it out. Please let me know if you need some more information on it. Okay. And please subscribe to my channel so that you will get notified on my upcoming videos. Till then, stay safe, stay happy, and have a nice day. Thank you.